New measurements and displays in the 89600B VSA software can reveal subtle or transient signal characteristics, helping you see through complexity to the answers you need. This oscillator startup event is not as complex as digital modulation or a radar pulse, but even basic system elements can have complicated and dynamic characteristics that are important to the performance of a design. A great way to analyze transient events is to capture the entire signal to memory without gaps in real time and then use different displays to examine every part of the signal. We use the 89600's IF level or power trigger and a negative trigger delay to capture the event beginning before the trigger itself. Replaying the signal capture with basic spectrum, we can see the signal turning briefly on and off, changing amplitude and frequency, and finally settling before playback repeats. It's easy to bring up and resize new traces to see more. This trace is the RF signal in the time domain. We can start and stop playback to see the power rise, fall, and rise again to settle at the final value. The time domain trace can be log scaled to show that the signal never fully turned off, though it appeared to in the earlier display. This trace precisely totals the power over the entire span, an improved version of Spectrum Analyzer Zero Span. The spectrogram shows hundreds or thousands of spectra at once. You can see how the signal and sidebands change rapidly. Any single spectrum can be selected from the spectrogram buffer for display and measurement. Adding another trace allows us to see more measurements at once, to see different views of the same signal. Here, trace C is added and set to display power spectral density. The new digital persistence display is a different way to see how a signal changes over time, and persistence is adjustable to optimize your view. The display reveals how the peak level and spectral width are changing each time the frequency reverses. The cumulative history display shows all measurements, and color indicates how often a specific amplitude and frequency value occurred. With flexible color mapping, it's a great way to focus on very rare or very frequent events and to quantify how often. A closer look at the first frequency reversal shows the amplitude change of the spectral peak associated with the frequency reversal. Some phenomena that are missed in one measurement are obvious in another. Frequency and density can be easily read by traditional markers or new fixed markers that can be placed anywhere in the display to read out the density at a frequency and amplitude point. The new cumulative history and digital persistence displays can be used in any domain on any measurement trace type, in addition to the spectrum example shown here. These flexible and powerful displays also apply to measuring complex digital signals, allowing you to see through complexity no matter what kind of signal you're measuring. For more information, go to agilent.com/find/89600B.